बैकअप फाइल, डोंट थिंक दैट इट इज सिंगल बैकअप फाइल, दैट माइट बी अ सिंगल बैकअप फाइल, दैट माइट बी अ मीडिया सेट, नॉट द पॉइंट. So, if you see the file, I'll tell you. Okay, tell you whether it is a media set or backup set. I'll tell you how to identify. Okay, right. Just to get an idea, guys. Usually in the organization, we don't do like this every time. Even though you are taking backups manually, first of all, we don't take it manually. We'll automate the backups, guys. Automatically, the backups will be generated. First thing. So, if it is an automation, every time the backup file name will be different. So nothing to worry about it. But again, sometimes you should be in a position to identify whether this is a backup set or media set. There are some chances this can be a media set also. Okay, guys, this can be a media set also. So in this single backup file might be two full backups will be there, or one full and one differential, one log backup will be there. You have to understand these are the loopholes, guys. These are the white spaces between the lines. Okay, you should be in a position to understand might be a single backup file or might be a media set. We don't know, right? So you can easily identify whether this is a media set or backup set. While restoring, you will select the backup file, right? Device, I'll tell you how to restore it. Again, I'm just restoring, guys. Nothing to worry. I'm selecting the file. This is my backup file. Double click on it. Select this file and choose contents. You can see how many files are there in this backup file. And what are the files? Either a full backup or a differential backup or a log backup. What is this file? What is the database name? Okay. And what is the server name? Position. When the first backup took, when the second backup took. Okay.
Sir, show me again, sir, how to get this screen.
While restoring, I'll show you. Okay. While restoring, I'll show you. Nothing to worry. Just you asked, right? Okay. Basic way, I just shown you, but while restoring, I'll show you. Okay. Right. So we can easily identify, guys, by using a backup set. Yes. By using a backup set, whether that is a single backup set or it's a media set, we can easily identify. Okay. By using these options and all, while restoring, you can choose. So nothing to worry. But again, there might be a chances. I'm not, see, sir, why we have to discuss all these things? Just to tell me how to take the backup. We have already discussed that one. Backup database, database name, to disk is equal to file name dot bak. If you ask me, just to tell me how to take the backup. This is the query to take the backup. If you ask me in the GUI, right click, go to tasks, backup, choose backup, give the path. Okay. Give the path, you have to remove in case if you want to take the same path. Guys, I'll tell you a simple way. Right click, tasks, backup. Okay. Then backup is completed. Sir, why, sir, you are explaining since 2 hours? You can see student backup file. See, I don't want to confuse you again. It's very easy to take the backup. Very, very easy. Or if you go for command method, backup database, database name to disk is equal to file name dot bak. That's it. That file name, your wish. I want to give your name as a file name, backup file name. You can give it. No one will stop you, but we'll follow organization standards. Okay.
Where we store this backup file, sir? In server disk, or is there any...
Yes, very good question. Yeah, very good question. See, in the server, there are different ways. In the organization, people will follow different strategies. Some people will keep it in the same server. Okay. Some people, they will take the backups to the shared location, guys. They will take the backup to the shared location. Okay. See, what is the problem if you keep in the same server, guys?
If is there any corruptions in the server, so we will not get restore the database. So that's why we...
Let me show you one picture. Okay, you will get a better idea. Okay, let me show you one picture. Just 1 minute. Let me share my screen. Check this one. Server has crashed. He is asking, where is the backup?
Sir.
Okay, so that is the challenge, guys. If you keep it in the same server, that is the challenge. If your server is crashed, backups also will be gone. Okay, so that's why we usually, there are two ways again. Either you can, again, you can maintain the same, you can maintain the, you can take the backups to the same location, guys. Okay, but in case if you need extra security, extra safety, we'll keep the backups in a separate server and we'll create a shared location. We'll take the backup to that shared location. In case if your server is crashed, your backups are stored in a separate path or separate location, so your backups will be safe. Okay, but you can manage the things. Either in, you can save the backups in a same server and you can go for a separate location also. It depends upon your organization requirements, and you cannot argue with them why you are saving in the same server. That's their standards.
Sir, is there any chance to place same two places, sir?
Yes, yes, yes. You can. Definitely, that is called mirror backup, guys. You can take the location, you can take the backup to multiple locations. Same backup, you can take the backup to multiple location. One can be shared, one can be your local. That is called mirror backup. Okay. Any questions, any doubts, please? So if you ask those who are not unable to concentrate, okay, if you ask, sir, tell me, I don't want to listen all this bullshit, sir. I just want to know how to take the backup. This is how we'll take the backup. Right click, tasks, backup. Okay. If you want to change the path, change the path. No, I'll take it to the default location. Click OK. That's it, guys. This is how we'll take the backup. Okay, you can see another backup is generated. Right? So very easy. Taking backup is very easy. But guys, you have to learn a lot of things. Now, you are professionals. You are not freshers. Okay, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years professionals means you have to read the white spaces between the lines. Okay, so these are the challenges while taking the backups. You might see in the backups with media sets, someone will took a fresher will took a backup with the same name to the same location. In that case, you should be in a position whether this is a backup set or media set. You should find it whether this is a backup set or media set. Okay, so these are the things will arise while taking the backups and while managing the backups, guys. Okay, any issue, any doubts?
No, sir.
So if you give the same name, it won't be failed. Yes, if you give the same name to the same location, it won't be failed. Simply, it will be appended. A single backup file is called backup set. Collection of backup set is called media set, guys. Okay, any doubts in the backup?
Sir, yes, while taking database backup, we have two options. One is the database and another one is the files or file groups.
I'll tell you. Nothing to worry. Right, guys. So this is your full backup. Let's go with the differential backup. Everything is clear with full backup, guys. Full backup, again, it will take the backup of the whole database. And guys, I have a question for all of you. Please try to respond. Very important question. My database size is, 500 GB, guys. Imagine my database size is 500. Sometimes you'll get these questions in the interview. How much time it will take? They will ask you, what is your biggest database? If you say 2 TB, okay, chalo, how much time it will take to take the backup of 2 TB database?
Four to six hours like that.
500 GB, worst case is you can tell, okay, 30 minutes, but best case is I'll tell you the range, guys. Best to worst, 10 minutes, okay, let's go with 15 minutes to 30 minutes, guys. 500 GB, in that way you can calculate. Okay, 1 TB, 30 minutes to 45 minutes. Best case is 30 minutes. Worst case is 45 minutes. Sometimes if the network is poor and if you are taking backups to the shared location, guys, again, it varies. If you are taking backups to a shared location, it depends upon your network speed. If you are taking backups to your local drive in the server itself, these are the timestamps, guys. If you're taking backups to the shared location, your backup speed depends upon your network speed, guys. So these are the timestamp only if you're taking backups to the local server. Okay. And if it is a 2 TB, hardly it will take 1 hour to, okay, 1.5 hour, guys. 2 TB backup, it will take 1 to 1.5 hour. Okay. Worst case, 2 hours it will take, might be. Okay, for 1 TB, calculated as a 1 hour. First case is 1 hour. Best case is in 45 minutes. It will be completed, guys. Okay, done. Yeah. My question is, this is not my question, guys. My question is, imagine you are taking backup of 500 GB, guys. You just started this backup at 10 AM. Okay, you just started this backup at 10 AM. Imagine how much time it will take. 500 GB, right? 10:30. Done. So now tell me, at 10:29, one transaction inserted into the database. At 10:29, before going to complete the backup, one transaction is inserted. Some or else 100 records are inserted. At 10:29, 100 records are inserted, guys, in the database. Now tell me, these 100 records are part of the current full backup or not?
Yes, sir.
MG is very confident. Yes, he will beat if anyone is there in front of him. Yes, sir. Tell me, guys. Yes, sir. No. Your backup is started at 10 a.m. itself, but at 10:29, before completing the backup, at 10:29, 100 records are inserted into the database. Now tell me, these 100 records are part of the current full backup file or not?
No, sir.
Okay. So tell me, your some 1,000 records are inserted. 1,000 records are inserted at 9:59. Now tell me, these 1,000 records are part of your current full backup or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 1,000 records are inserted at 10:31. Now tell me, by the time backup is completed, by 10:30 itself backup is completed, but 1,000 records are inserted at 10:31. Now tell me, these 1,000 records are part of the current full backup or not?
No, sir.
Okay, so this is yes, guys. Before backup, if you inserted any records, okay, the records will be part of the current full backup file. And this is also yes. Okay. Before completing the backup, at least 1 second before, if any records are there inserted in the database, guys, okay, those records are also part of the current full backup. Don't think it will take the backup of all the transaction at 10 a.m. 10 to 10:30 a.m. If any transactions came, it will take the backup of those transactions also. Before completing the full backup, if any transactions are inserted, those transactions are also part of your current full backup file.
Again? Sir, that depends upon the checkpoint, sir.
See, that is different thing, okay? So, whether it is a checkpoint or that is different thing completely. See, here we have committed and uncommitted, okay? If these 1,000 records are committed, of course, committed and uncommitted also, it will take the backup. But if the records are uncommitted, while restoring that particular full backup, it will roll back the uncommitted transactions. You got the point?
No, sir.
What is... See, here checkpoint is completely different. Okay. Checkpoint is completely different. And first of all, it will take the backup of these 1,000 records. Whatever records came during this 10 to 10:29 or 10:30, it will take the backup first. But again, yes, in transactions, we have two types of transactions. One is committed transaction, second one is uncommitted transaction. It will take the backup of all the transactions, committed and uncommitted transactions. Okay, but during restoration, it will roll back the uncommitted transactions. Got the point? If the transactions are uncommitted, by that time is checkpoint not run, it will roll back whatever transactions are there.
So during restoration?
During restoration, it will take care of it.
But it will take the backup of uncommitted transactions?
Yes, it will take the backup of the whole. This is very important intro question, guys. While taking backup, what transactions it will take the backup, committed or uncommitted? Answer is both. It will take the backup of the committed transactions and uncommitted transactions. Committed means permanently stored transactions. Uncommitted means it's a temporary. Okay, it has to be commit. It has to commit. Okay, it's waiting for commit. Okay, guys. So again, nothing to worry.
It's going to take backup from the disk and the buffer memory also.
Yes, correct. You are correct. It will take the backup completely from the disk and your whatever buffer pool is there. It will take the backup of that particular buffer pool also. It will take the backup of complete committed transactions and uncommitted transactions. If transactions are uncommitted while restoring, it will roll back those transactions.
But if we take differential backup, what will happen?
I'll tell you. We haven't started differential backup. So we'll discuss during differential backup. Okay. So as of
during now, during restoration, so the uncommitted transactions are not going
to any backup during restorations, all uncommitted transactions will be rolled back.
Rollback
means cancel, guys. Okay. If, for example, if you have 100 records in the database, okay, 100 records are there in the database. Imagine if 100 records are committed means permanently stored in the disk, guys. Okay. Uncommitted means it will store in your log file. 1000 records are stored in your log file, guys. I told you, right? Log file is a temporary storage area. Now, if in MDF file, you have 100 records. Okay. In NDF file, you have 1000 records. Now, when you generate a full backup, okay, it will take the backup of 1100 records, guys, total records. In this, while restoring, if you ask me, sir, how many records you will get when you restore? Okay, if you ask me, tell me, guys, when you restore, how many records you will get it? 100 or 1100?
100
records. 100, sir. 100.
Why? Because 100. These 100 are committed. Okay, you will get the committed transaction. And it will restore remaining 1000 also. It will restore it first. And after restoring, it will roll back, guys. Means cancel the transactions. Whatever transaction just restored, it will cancel. Again, somewhat internals, guys. Nothing to worry. Those who don't understand this concept, please don't worry. So we are discussing the backups. That's it. Okay. So in this case, it will take the backup of all the committed and uncommitted transactions. But while restoring, it will roll back uncommitted transactions, guys. Roll back means undo. You know, right? Undo, control Z.
Yes, sir.
Undo. It will undo the roll uncommitted transactions. It will only keep a committed transactions when you restore the database. Okay. Clear, guys? Any issues, any doubts, please?
Sir, one issue. Sir, during restoration, how come it's know that those 1000 records are committed or uncommitted?
That's called with the help of LSN numbers, log sequence numbers. Okay. Each transaction will be committed or uncommitted. Your LSN will record this information.
Okay.
Your log file will record a lot of properties. Yes, please.
Sir, we can track those uncommitted
records. Yes, we can track it. You can track it in the error log, SQL Server error log. You can check how many transactions are uncommitted. You can check in the SQL Server error log.
Okay, sir. Thanks.
You can simply see 1000 records are rolled back. Okay, sorry.
After restoration.
After restoration.
Those LDF files would get deleted, sir.
No. Files won't be deleted. Never. Deleted. Only transactions will be rollbacked.
Rollback means
cancel. You see, now I just type this, right? Rollback, right? Let me control Z. It was gone, right? Undo. Yes, you know undo, right? While typing the document, you can do undo, right?
Yes, sir.
If you by mistake, if you type something, you can undo. Or if you miss something, you can undo. So undo means what? It is simply going to roll back. Rollback or undo, both are same. Roll forward or redo, both are same. Redo, undo, roll back, roll forward. These are the important terminologies in the log file. Just go through the log file, these terminologies, what is rollback, roll forward, redo, undo, both are same. Okay, roll back, roll forward, this is one set. Redo, undo, this is one set. Okay, so undo means simply it will first restore all the 1100 transactions and it will check how many are there. Uncommitted transactions, it will again roll back all uncommitted transactions, cancel it. Okay, so that you cannot see in the database those transactions. You cannot see in the database.
How to restore those rollback transactions, sir?
If you ask like that, you should be good in commit and all. Okay, so how can we restore uncommitted transactions if any transaction is committed or uncommitted? For example, if I give like this insert into table name, employee, values, okay, 1, Suresh, 1000. This is one record, right? 100.
Okay.
So remember, this is whenever you're running any transaction, SQL Server will add these two commands, guys, begin, tran, and commit. if it is committed, if you give commit, this transaction will be saved permanently. Okay. If you don't give commit, this is uncommitted transaction.
Sir, but all SQL Server transactions are auto-committed, right, sir?
Auto-committed. That's what I'm saying. If you don't give, SQL Server will give commit.
Okay, sir.
If you simply give like this, this is auto-committed transaction. Okay.
Implicit.
SQL Server will add begin tran to this. And it will give commit. Sometimes developers wantedly will give uncommitted transaction. See, if you don't give both parameters, it is a committed transaction. But if you give begin tran, if you don't give commit, then this is uncommitted transaction. It will wait until I am getting commit or not. Until okay. Years and years, it will wait till you give commit to a query.
Okay,
so how can we commit the uncommitted transaction? Simply by just giving commit. That's it. If you run commit on the database, that's it. But at the end of the transactions, if you run commit, automatically those transactions will be committed. Okay. If you don't give anything, these parameters, those transactions are auto-committed transactions. You don't need to commit anything from your side.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Guys, again, we are deviating the topic. Okay. So those who don't know these things, okay, please, again, nothing to worry. Just know how to take the backup. That's it, guys. This is limited to backups only. Okay. If you are still interested, if you are still enthusiastic, go and check it. Commit and uncommit, roll back, roll forward, redo, undo, log file architecture. Go and check it, guys. You will get a better idea. Okay. Any questions, any doubts in the full backup?
Sorry, sir. My last question is that we are going to track the uncommitted transactions using LSNM, right, sir?
Yes, correct.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, guys. So let's jump into the differential backup. I thought to complete all 10 backups today. Unfortunately, okay, only full backup is discussed. Let's complete this differential backup at least. So what is this differential backup, guys? Again, I'll give you the same WhatsApp example. What is that WhatsApp example? At 2 o'clock, night 2 o'clock, regularly you are going to take backup, or your WhatsApp is going to take backup on your messages, right? Now tell me, this is the scenario, okay? So now if you understood this concept properly, at 2 a.m., it will take the backup of WhatsApp, right? Imagine I have 100 charts. Means if I just messaged 100 people, 100 charts are there. Or else let me go with one chart. Why to confuse? Only one person. I'm just charting with one person, guys. Charting with one person. One chart is there. One chart is active. Okay. 100 messages are there in this one chart. 100 messages are there. Today is Tuesday, right? So today at 2 a.m., it will generate the full differential backup. Today at 2 a.m., it will generate a differential backup. 2 a.m., the backup will be generated. Okay. Tomorrow again, it will run. Tomorrow at 2 a.m., again, the differential backup will be generated. Okay. So what is the time difference, guys? 24 hours, right? During these 24 hours, how many extra messages came? See, for example, today you said good morning. Okay. Just good morning. How are you? Okay. How are you? Or else we will discuss, right? How is the things going on, like that. So already 100 messages are there. You just chart in these 24 hours, you just send messages like this. Good morning. How are you? Next time when it is taking a differential backup, it will take the backup of only the new messages, guys. These two messages. Okay, so on what basis it will take? Again, every 24 hours, it will take a backup? No. So this is your Sunday full backup, guys. I just want to explain, or else let me explain in this way. You will get a good clarity. Okay. Google differential backup. Listen carefully. Okay. Done. Right. Your differential backup. Let me explain the statement first. What is the differential backup? What is the definition for differential backup? Differential backup means it will take the backup of all the transactions since last full backup. Okay. Very important definition. It will take the backup of all the transactions since last full backup, guys. Okay. So in the organization, we'll have backup strategies. Interview question, guys. Backup strategies. What is the backup strategy? Some companies will follow these strategies. Every Sunday, they will take the full backup. Every day, they will take the differential backup. Okay. And every 15 minutes, they will go for log backups, guys.
Log backup.
Okay. So every Sunday, they will take the full backup. Every day they will take the differential backup. Okay, every day they will take the differential backup. So if you go for full backup, right? What is the meaning of differential backup, guys? Since last full backup, whatever transactions are there, it will take the backup of those newly added transactions. Okay, since last full backup, it will take the backup of those newly added transactions. You took the full backup on Sunday. Just please. Okay, let me complete. Then we'll discuss about internals. Okay, right. So you took the backup on Sunday. You took the full backup on Sunday. Okay. Now on Monday, if you take the differential backup from Sunday to Monday, whatever transactions are there on Monday differential backup, it will take the backup of all the transactions from Sunday to Monday. Now you are taking a differential backup on Tuesday. Tell me, guys, from what day to what day the transactions will contain the differential backup? Tuesday differential backup.
Sunday after full backup converts on Tuesday, sir.
If you see here, since last full backup, when is my last full backup, guys? Sunday, right?
Sunday.
So Tuesday differential backup contains Sunday to Tuesday, whatever transactions are there, it will take the backup of those transactions. If you are taking a differential backup on Wednesday, Sunday to Wednesday. If you are taking differential backup on Thursday, Sunday to Thursday. If you are taking differential backup on Friday, Sunday to Friday. If you are taking differential backup on Saturday, Sunday to Saturday. If you are taking differential backup on Sunday, tell me, guys, Sunday. If you are taking differential backup on Sunday.
Only Sunday data.
Only Saturday to Sunday.
Are you sure?
Sunday to Sunday.
Sir,
what is the difference?
Sir,
if already Sunday is
Sunday to Sunday. Sir, is there a duplicacy?
I'll tell you. Okay, so let me go like this. Okay, so imagine every 1 hour I'll take the full backup. Like this also will be there. Every 1 hour I'll take, or else every 4 hours I'll take the full backup. Every 4 hours I'm taking the full backup, guys. Every 1 hour I'm taking a differential backup. Okay, so if you go to this diagram, imagine at 7 o'clock, listen carefully, guys, very simple, it's not difficult thing, very simple thing, guys, listen carefully. At 7 a.m. one record is inserted in the database. Okay, at 7 a.m. one record is inserted in the database. At 10 a.m. you took the full backup. By 10 a.m. what are the records are there? It will take the backup of those transactions, right? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Till 10 a.m. only one record is there in my database. So when you generate a full backup, it took the backup of that single record. Agree? Clear? Yes, sir. Is this clear? Fine. Now again at 1 p.m., four records are inserted. 2, 3, 4 records are inserted in my database. Again at 1 p.m., three records are inserted in my database. If you took the differential backup at 2 p.m., what is the definition of the differential backup, guys? It will take the backup since last full backup, right?
When is the last full backup?
10 a.m.
So 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. What are the new transactions came, guys?
Only 3 transactions.
These new are 2, 3. Added, right? 2, 3, 4. So when you generate a differential backup, it will take the backup of the newly added transactions. Is this clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
From last full backup to up to the current differential backup, whatever new transactions are there, it will take the backup of only newly added transactions. That's it. Since last full backup to the till you are going to take a differential backup, whatever new transactions are there, it will take the backup of only newly added transactions. Is this clear or not? Everyone, please.
Yes, sir.
Everyone,
yes, sir.
Is this clear? Correct. Yes, okay. Yes, at 4 p.m., at 4 p.m., again, 5 and 6 records are added. Only these two records are added. Okay. In my database, at 4 p.m., these two records are added. Now, if you generate the 6 p.m. differential backup, tell me, it will take the backup of 5 and 6, or it will take the backup of 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 records.
Sir, No, sir, only 5 and 6, sir.
Why? What is the definition? What is the definition of the differential backup? Tell me.
Since last full backup,
how many records are there? Only one record there. One record is there. Okay. Since last full backup, how many records are newly added, guys?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sir.
2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4 here. 5, 6 here. Yeah. Total, how many records? At 6
p.m. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 5 records.
Total 5 records.
Any confusion here? Let me know, please.
No, sir.
Since last full backup, how many newly added records are there? It will take the backup of all the newly added records. The benchmark, the base is last full backup. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Agree, guys? Now again at 8 p.m., how many records are there? 7, 8 records are added, guys. Again, yes, you generated here. Listen carefully. At 10 p.m., you generated a full backup. Of course, till 10 p.m., how many records are there? It will take the backup of all the records, right?
Eight.
This is clear, right? 8 records are there. It took the backup of all the 8 records. Now at 11 p.m., just 9 and 10 records are added, guys. At 11 p.m., 9 and 10 records are added. Now you just took the full differential backup at 2 a.m. Now how many records will be backed up? Tell me.
Only two
records.
Why? Nine, because 10. Now the full backup chain is changed from 10 a.m. to 11 p.m. 10 p.m. You got the point? Earlier,
yes, sir.
10 a.m. is the base. So it just took the backup of all the transactions since 10 a.m. But again, you just took a fresh full backup, right? Now it will calculate from the last full backup, which is 10 p.m. full backup. After 10 p.m., only two records are added. So the latest differential backup contains the transactions from 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. There are two newly added records are there. It will take the backup of only two newly added records. Guys, tell me how many of you understood this concept?
Yes, sir. Please,
please raise your hands. I'm sure only half of you understood, remaining half. Tell me, guys, no issues. I'll explain again. This is very important. Differential backups are very important.
I have a question.
Yes.
For full backup means only for 12 hours?
No. It depends. See, I can take full backup for 12 hours. I can take full backup for 24 hours. I can take full backup for weekly. It's my wish.
Okay.
It's my strategy. Okay. If it is a critical database, I'll take it for every 24 hours. I'll take a full backup.
Okay,
or if it is a normal database in the organization, usually every 1 week we'll take full backup, guys. Mm-hmm. Okay. Is it clear? Any issues, any doubts? Okay, so let me explain again with the WhatsApp example. Now you'll get a clarity, guys. Right? So WhatsApp, every Sunday it will run full backup. So you have 100 messages. Okay, Monday you send 2 messages, guys. Monday you just send 2 messages. Monday, you just send 2 messages. Okay. Now tell me, on Monday differential backup, how many messages will be backed up? If you took Monday differential backup, how many messages?
Two.
Very good. Okay. This is Monday. Tuesday, you just added 4 messages. Okay, now Tuesday differential backup contains how many messages, guys?
6 or 4.
Six, Wednesday. You just added 4 more messages. Now Wednesday differential backup contains
10.
Thursday you just deleted 2 messages. Now Thursday differential backup contains
8.
Deleted. These are deleted, guys. These 2 messages are deleted.
12, sir.
Two messages are deleted. Okay, total. Deleted, guys. Deleted.
Deleted.
Eight, sir.
See, that is different thing. That is automatically when you restore, how many records you will get? 12 records you will get or 8 records you will get? Tell me.
Eight.
I'll agree. Those are the transactions that will be recorded inside in your differential backup. Okay, but when you restore the differential backup, how many you will get?
Eight,
right?
Sir.
No,
eight.
Done. Okay. Now at Friday, someone took the full backup on your WhatsApp. Now Saturday, you just added 8 messages. Okay. The girl is not responding. Then you send 8 messages. Okay. Now what you are going to do? Now at Saturday differential backup, how many messages will be backed up? You just took the backup of whatever records, whatever backups are added, only those backups it will take the backup. There is no question of confusion here. Single point differential backup will take the backup of all the transactions since last full backup. The last full backup is the benchmark for the differential backups. If you ask, sir, how it will work internally, what is the mechanism, I'll explain tomorrow. Okay. But is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Any issues are there?
Yes, sir.
It's clear, right?
Right, sir.
Done. So now tell me, every Sunday I'm taking full backup. Every Sunday I'm taking full backup. Okay, at night 10 a.m. Every day at night 10 p.m. I'm taking differential backup. Okay, so Monday at 10 p.m. you are going to take a differential backup. So all the transactions from Sunday 10 a.m. Okay, please mute it. Okay, so if you take the backup of, if you take differential backup on Monday from Sunday 10 a.m. to till Monday 10 p.m., it will take all the backups. Okay, Tuesday, if you generate a differential backup from Sunday 10 a.m. to till Tuesday 10 p.m. Okay, Monday, Sunday 10 a.m. to Tuesday 10 p.m.
Sir, Monday 10 p.m. sir.
When you are generating a differential backup?
Okay, night 10 p.m. sir.
Monday, apologies. Okay, till Monday 10 p.m. Okay, Tuesday, okay. If you generate a differential backup, again, Sunday 10 a.m. to?
Tuesday 10 p.m.
Wednesday, Sunday 10 a.m. to?
Wednesday 10 p.m.
Listen carefully, I'll ask one question. Okay, Thursday, Sunday 10 a.m. to?
Thursday 10 p.m.
Friday? Sunday 10 a.m. to, the Friday differential backup contains Sunday 10 a.m. to, okay, Friday 10 p.m. Now my database is corrupted, okay? Now my database is corrupted at Friday, let's go with Saturday, guys. Saturday. Now tell me how many full backups and how many differential backups you are going to use to restore my database.
One full backup.
Six differential backup.
Very good, excellent.
Six differential backup.
One.
Please reconnect again. Please reconnect again with the same link. Please reconnect.